Marin, the lovely Irene, and Artemis, because Aimee is taking a nap. So we're just taking a quick break from Otakon, which is located in Las Vegas, Nevada, to have a swag haul. So
yeah, a swag haul.
And Irene has this really cool shirt she'll like to show you guys.
I absolutely love The Flash. So they have this shirt back up here. And show you, but it's just like a maroon tank top, which is super cute, and it has the symbol on it, the Flash, and it's like, what'd you say, like 3D?
3D.
It kind of, yeah, it like bubbles up from the shirt, so like if you listen, it sounds kind of like,
yeah. There's a texture there.
There's texture.
And it's machine washable, she says.
And pliable, so yeah. And so I got that, and so I'm super excited because I really love it.
She loves The Flash. Alright, and then another thing we found was it's this really cute place. I don't even know if I have their card, but they made little keychains. So Aimee got me this Sailor Venus keychain here, and then when you turn it, it turns into Sailor V. She has Sailor Uranus. But she's downstairs right now, and then Irene has a few of the same
characters.
And I got
some too. I got this one for my sister. It's Sailor Neptune, and it just looks like the same on the back. But yeah, I got that one for my sister.
So
cute.
Nice.
That was her favorite. And then my favorite has always been Sailor Mercury.
And this is pretty cool.
And then this is pretty cool. You know, her rum.
Has the visor.
Yeah.
Pretty snazzy schmazzy.
Awesome.
That's pretty cool. And then they have advertisements for like MomoCon. They have advertisements for Snafu, which is our local anime con too.
But we found this card on the ground. It's like Japanese, the game, and actually the guy was promoting it, which actually sounds really fun. So it's like a bunch of cards, and it's to learn the language and you can play with other people. Basically, you're trying to like end up making sentences. So it's like you're learning the language, which probably tomorrow I'm like.
I know. I'm like tempted.
It
we can play.
Really cool. But we did find this one on the ground,
it's
and we just
played.
It up, yeah, because my sister was like,
get
my sister was like, give me some free stuff. And we're like, it's
free.
It's actually pretty cool. So I got this little one, and it's Howl from Howl's Moving Castle. And he said it was a sticker, but then like it has a badge on it. And I was just like, okay, either way, you can take it off so it doesn't bother me. I got him. I got my other sister, who said, give me some free stuff. It wasn't free, but I got it. Her favorite Sailor Scout was Jupiter.
We're just, yeah.
It better sure be. It was, though. It sounds familiar. Anyways, I mean, who doesn't like Sailor Jupiter?
Seriously.
It's amazing. So I got that with her. And then also, of course, I got my other sister, Neptune, because we all know she likes it.
Yes.
And she uses it for whatever. I mean, you could take the clip off and make it into a bookmark, or put a sticky on the back. I mean, it's whatever.
Possibilities are endless.
Yeah. And then I also got Sophie from Howl's Moving Castle as well. Oh, and luggage tags, so you can use it as like whatever you want. And then I got Totoro.
Which is
we dressed, yeah. Me and Jennifer got these cute little bracelets.
Which, oh my gosh, she has such cute stuff.
She also has an online store, so we got her.
It's from Unique Creations by Aimee. So she specializes in making jewelry, and we're gonna take them out of the little bags because they are very detail oriented. For example, if you like Doctor Who, so this is what it looks like, but she actually
hand draws
these.
Every little thing on there.
So as you can see, this is a Dalek. Maybe I could. It doesn't.
Pull it back.
Yeah. So there's a Dalek, and then this theme is Dominate. So there's like a little gag there. I got it because it was funny. The Dalek there. Some handcuffs, and there's just so much detail involved with that. So there's one of the ones. Show them yours.
Yeah, she's a super sweet. Anyway, so she like gives each of her bracelets like a name. So mine is like books are portable magic. So basically the theme of mine, because I was gonna, she has Harry Potter ones, and so she has one for each house, which I really wanted the Ravenclaw one, but I feel like I have a lot of that. So anyways. This one, I don't know if you can see, but it has little books on it and everything. All of these little books on it. And then, let me see here. It's just like a little flower thing, like whatever. And even more little books. Some weird little faces are on here as well. And then little thing that I have, a little charm that she wrote. And so she does handwrite all these, which I'm like, wow, you have a nice penmanship.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you can see it, but mine says, books are portable magic. And yeah, she handmade these little books out of clay. I mean, look at that. It's like insane. And she actually has to twist on all these little, like the gems and like all the little metal bits. Like it's hand screwed on there. So she uses little pliers and like, will twist it on there. So each charm on this, I was like, oh my God. So yeah, so a lot of attention to detail and it's just super cute. And she has them in like a variety of colors, but each one has like a different name. And she remembers really well each individual piece. Yeah. She tells you like what she's doing, what she's making, how she did it, how she hand drew all of it and made it smaller, how some things were made from like sea salt.
Yeah.
I don't even know.
It was
amazing.
Amazing detail. And then I also got myself a Spock one. Live long and prosper. Maybe I could get a different angle of that, but you could just see so much detail that she puts into these. So if you guys are interested, she is Unique Creations by Amy.
Oh, and something else that she did, which she told us, and like if you get the bracelet, well, when we got the bracelet, she also gave it to us for free. She invented an adapter, or like, I don't know, invented, but she got like an adapter. So basically they're bracelets, but if you want to wear it as a necklace, she gives you the adapter to it. So basically you'll just clip on the bracelet to it
right there.
Yeah,
and it turns into a necklace.
Into a necklace.
I don't know if you can see it, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we can model it.
Yes,
we can show you guys, but yeah, it'll just turn into like a necklace, which yeah, so you have that option.
And then last but not least is a fun little grab bag. These gals, I don't even know who they are. There's probably, but I got the $20 grab bag and I remember they made some really cute stuff. So this one has a guaranteed charm inside. So would you like to do the honors and see what's on the inside of that? So this is super cute. So Charmander bookmark.
Oh, so this is a little Suzushu. Is the artist or whatever, or
that's the artist.
The shop. That's cute. Can you wear it?
Yeah.
I was saying it's like a little bracelet, but it's made out of those little stars.
Is it origami or paper? Oh, it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, it's paper.
This is so cute. So this is actually like a paper. You see all the details there. It's a paper, like origami. Bracelet, that is so cool.
Oh, cute.
Buttons, yay!
Secret buttons. So this one has Moroku from Inuyasha.
There it is. Cute. Look how freaking cute that is. Oh my goodness.
You got Koga. Koga, right? Koga?
Yeah, Koga.
Koga from also Inuyasha.
Cute.
I don't know who this
that
is.
Looks like them.
I was gonna say, I think it's a Attack on Titan. I haven't read that yet, so.
It's good stuff. There's a lot of stuff in there.
And then the free little charm that she got is. I think it's Pokemon.
Yeah, it is.
Eevee's? It's Eevee, the water one.
Look how cute that is.
Damn! They had this cute little charm one that was. A cat coming out of a banana.
That was freaking adorable. Hey everybody, it's Jennifer and Irene, and we're taking a break at OtakuCon Vegas. And Irene's gonna show us some lovely, lovely things that we just bought because we went shopping.
So I didn't get this, Jennifer did.
Mm-hmm.
But she got this shirt from a. Well, I don't know if it was like a panel, but it was like an exhibition of sumo wrestlers, which is actually pretty cool to have the two signatures. There's Yama, and there's the other, Yamba. It's very similar names.
Very similar.
But yeah, she got that.
Yep.
It's a men's museum for her boyfriend.
Yes.
One of many, because she's so popular.
I know, no.
And, I got this.
Last
one. I got these little hair ties, but these are for my niece. And I got them in this color because she is such a huge fan of
Nightmare Before Christmas. So, you know, representing Jack.
Yep.
Got that. And then I got this one for myself. And it's just a little headband. You can either wear it, I guess, like bunny ears style. Or if you actually just tuck it in, you can make a bow. And it'll be cute over there. But yeah. And I got it kind of matching.
Matching.
That's adorable. And Jennifer came across this lovely lady. She does makeup. And so her brand is called Surreal Makeup.
It's amazing.
It's so freaking cool. And her name's Amanda Baker. These are like all natural ingredients style stuff. So you just got the makeups. And they each have a name, and like they're really pigmented and super soft.
They're amazing.
Super cool. Super freaking cool. And then we also got some lip stuff also. Mm-hmm. She said it wasn't made from, it's made from
coconut oil, vitamin E oil,
calcium, sweet almond oil, vitamin E oil, macadamia nut oil, coconut oil, stevia, flavor oil. But yeah, like super, super like,
it's like magic on your lips.
Yeah, it's like moisturized and like they're really pigmented, like ridiculously so. But I got a set, and Jennifer also got a set, so that's pretty cool. Gotta say I really like it. And she had her makeup done, and she's like, I did it at like 6:30 in the morning, and it was ready like close to 12.
Yep.
And she's like, I haven't touched it up at
all. It lasts forever. It's
and
so
it
cool.
Looks super bright, like the colors are bright. We got some keychains. This one's mine, and it has Calcifer from Howl's Moving Castle.
Got more keychains.
She got this, which is just like a terrarium.
Yeah, that's mine.
Terrarium keychain. Has a lot of people on it. And then we got our friend Aini. This Jibby says Gigi. Mm-hmm. I got these pins. Mm-hmm. And the Studio Jibby, obviously, it's Kiki's Delivery Service. And we've got Gigi. And this, her face in a little cup, like coffee cup, and it has Gigi's on it.
It's so cute.
Super cute. But I love Studio Jibby. And so I got these for the forest break. Mm-hmm. Super awesome, isn't it cute? And you can kind of see the deer. Right there. Super awesome. I also got, I got this one. It says Alice in Wonderland.
There you go.
You have a Cheshire Cat and everything. I just thought it was super cool. It's a postcard, but, you know. I got Totoro.
Yay, so cute.
So cute. And my all-time faves. I got Howl's Moving Castle, which I think is so adorable. So cute. And then I got this one, which is Kiki's Delivery Service. Yay. And super cute. Again, all postcards. Best.
Super cute stuff. Okay, I'm still at Otakon. Irene's over there. And we're gonna open some mystery boxes of Star Wars. So let's open these. This is the first thing that caught my eye. Princess Leia.
Talking fleshy. Who's talking? What did she say?
Stop it! Don't kill your husband!
I can't hear it.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi, your mom, and my only hope.
No! Stop it!
So, it's a drink set. Stormtrooper, Millennium Falcon. That's fresh. I have to open this up. It's a BB-8 ultimate leader mix of it.
It's a what?
BB-8.
I know that! I was like, well, what?
I don't know. I'll open it later. This is my belief in life. Do or do not, there is no try. But it's a necklace of it. Yoda. The force is strong with this one.
What is it?
So it's a mug.
A mug?
Yeah.
Who's on it? Who's on it?
Huh?
I said, who's on it?
Darth Vader Imperial mug.
Nice. That's my homeboy right there.
Yeah.
What does it say?
Yeah, I made my own
thing. Force is strong with this one.
Nice.
Death Star Canteen, property of the Empire. Do not remove.
It's a Millennium Falcon seal contract. Make some cakes in there, some ice. That's legit.
That's really
cool. I'd say yes, it's totally worth the $50-something. So we're going to switch.
Definitely better than the blind box you got at San Fu.
It's a Harry Potter blind box.
More my style. All right. Some Deathly Hallows earrings and Deathly Hallows necklace from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. It's a pin. It just says Stupefy.
Nice.
Stupefy. Oh snap! It's a Slytherin beanie. You got a Harry Potter keyring from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and it's just a Thunderbird.
Oh, that's cute.
So it's just a like squishy keychain.
We got a bonus mini box.
And a mini box now. Oh, you got a Star Trek.
Nice.
What is it? It's a collectible kit, so whatever is inside. And then you got a...
Oh my, is that the real deal?
Legendary boss key? I don't know.
Okay. I'm like, is that a real deal?
I don't know what this is.
Legend of Zelda, young lady.
So it includes exclusive replica of the... Fabled boss key.
That's fancy as hell.
I'll take your word for it, and that's it.
That's it in there? There we go. And Irene.
I'm dying. Hello. So, we're gonna open up this Star Wars
mystery. I've watched the Star Wars, like the originals.
What?
But none of the new ones.
Okay, good.
Aside from Rogue One.
Yeah.
But I haven't seen any of the ones with Anakin and stuff. And I'm not like a, like I like Star Wars, but I can't say I'm like a huge fan. Like in the sense that I like them, but what I mean when I say I'm not a huge fan is that I don't know a lot about Star Wars, so I might hold something up and be like, yeah.
Let's switch places.
That's what I want to do to have these people now.
People are starting to lose their fucking minds.
Yeah.
They need to come and fuck you.